fingertips. My imagination brings a smile up to my lips. Oh, fascinated, I'm moving fast. Oh, I'm optimistic as the days go past. Oh, opportunity is here for me. So come along and take a look, because I want you to see.
Fashion is very important. It is a life enhancing and like everything, and it gives you pleasure. It's worth well doing, says the Westwood. A cheerful good afternoon and a hearty welcome to one and all present here. I hope everyone is safe and sound in this pandemic situation. This is Gayatri from Fashion Design Department. I'll be the host for the day, and I take a pleasure by welcoming you all. Now I request the felicitation.
So very good afternoon to one and all connected here. On behalf of Dr. MGR Educational Research Institute, Adayalam to Phase 2 Campus, I would like to welcome you all to this national level workshop on bridal illustration, which has been organized by Department of Fashion Design. So we are very much happy that this event has been organized as part of our founder chancellor's birthday celebration, which is coming up tomorrow. So I first of all thank our honorable president, engineer AC Sarankumar sir, for his kind approval today to conduct this wonderful workshop which is going on. So next I would like to congratulate the Department of Fashion Design, HOD Mrs. Mahmuda Begum, and Director IOD Mr. Nadeem sir, as well as the other faculty members, Ms. Dharanya ma'am and Ms. Gayatri ma'am, who have involved themselves in coordinating and organizing this event successfully. Next, I would like to appreciate the technical support which has been rendered for this particular program by Mr. Ganesh Babu, System Admin of Department of Computer Science. So next, I would like to welcome the speaker of today's session, Ms. Zia Khan, who is a fashion illustrator. So thank you so much, ma'am, for accepting our invite to take this wonderful session. So I think your experience, your skill and your knowledge will reach n number of people who are going to watch this program live. As you all know, I mean, fashion industry is one of a unique industry in our country. So there is a lot of opportunities, especially with the particular industry. So in Nava University, I think we have been successfully conducting the BSc Fashion Design course. So a lot of students have already joined the particular course. So there's always passion for fashionist. So I think there are plenty of career opportunities with regards to this particular fashion industry. So the fashion department has always been taking so much of efforts in organizing these kind of wonderful, useful workshops and seminars, which are benefited to huge number of students. And then apart from that, the participants who have registered from other institutions and other organizations for this particular learning session. So I once again welcome all the participants, especially, for showing your interest, registering for these kind of wonderful, knowledgeable workshops to enhance your knowledge. So attending these kind of events are always very important. So I once again welcome the participants, especially for this wonderful workshop, and also the speaker once again for accepting the invitation. And I also congratulate the department for taking tremendous efforts towards conducting a lot of online events, especially during this particular pandemic period. So they have been organizing plenty of events, and today is another day, another event. So I wish the department all the best and wish this event a grand success. And I also thank the department for inviting me to talk a few words. So thank you all. Have a great session and have a great day too. Thank you all.
Thank you, sir. Now I invite inspiring personality, Ms. Mahuda Begum ma'am, the head of our department, to give the welcome address of our guest of honor.
Thank you, Ms. Gayatri. A very good afternoon to one and all gathered here. It gives me immense pleasure to welcome you all on behalf of Dr. MGR Educational and Research Institute, University, Department of Fashion Design for this one-day national-level workshop on the topic bridal illustration. On behalf of Fashion Design Department, I would like to thank our Founder Chancellor A.C. Shanmugam Sir and our President A.C.S. Arun Kumar Sir for granting approval to conduct this online workshop in a successful manner. I would like to thank all the other dignitaries of our campus for their endless support in conducting events. Today, to enrich our knowledge and to give a clear focus on bridal illustration, we have here with us an eminent fashion illustrator, Ms. Zia Khan. We feel proud and honored to welcome you here. A heartfelt welcome to all the participants from all over the world. Last but not the least, I would like to welcome all the other dignitaries, my colleagues, and technical support people who always help us to make all the programs a grand success. I welcome you all once again. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Now I invite Dharanya to give introduction of our chief guest.
It's a great honor for me to introduce and welcome the chief guest of the workshop, Ms. Zia Khan. She has done her Bachelor of Arts from Lucknow University. Then she completed Diploma in Fashion Design. She started her career as a fashion faculty in Institute of Fashion. She has participated in many fashion shows as a designer in Chennai. She started her own garment brand named Lucknow Print. She also worked as a guest lecturer in various places such as WLICI and NIFT Chennai and ICAT, RAFD, and SRM University, etc. I would like to welcome you once again, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Now I invite Ms. Zia Khan to take over the session. The stage is yours, ma'am.
Good afternoon, everyone. I really thanks to Dr. MGR University who got me the opportunity to teach to students. And I'm really thanks to President Engineer ACCR Ram Kumar Sir and Mr. Director Nadeem Sir, Institute of Design. He's always behind me whenever I will do anything. So especially thanks to Nadeem Sir and HOD of Mahmuda Begum of Fashion Department. So I like to thank everybody who's gave me the opportunity to part of your team. And I hope I will teach, I will pray to my God, I'll teach the student in this, whatever you gave me the opportunity, I'll teach well to them. And they will learn with this session. And in the future also, I like to teach them if I'll get the opportunity. Thank you so much to all of your team. And I like to start my work. Thank you so much.
Ma'am, you can start your another camera.
So I just start from very beginning part. Like bridal wear is something like very different and it's like high level of illustration. So I will already place your one crockery. This is 10 head pudding crockery. So I'll start with this. And I took the very basic line of lehenga. You can see this very basic line of
your garment. I just take that. And inside of the portion, I'll erase it. So now, what is the problem will come, especially in the illustration of
the embellishment part, how to show the embellishment part in your the garments. So what you can do is, it's a very easy thing. You can do the your embellishment part in your papers. This is gateway sheet paper, and you can trace it where you want to place. You just trace it. See, I designed this motifs and all in this, and I'll place in my lehenga something like this. And with the help of nail, I just transfer my design on my lehenga. So this way it will be easy to implement your embellishment part on your lehengas. Here only the difficult part come whenever you do the illustration, especially the bridal wear. So see, with the help of nail or nail, anything, you just transfer your design. So you can place it, like suppose the same design will come here, so you again you can place it and you can trace. So this way you can do the placement of your motifs. So you can see here, already I did the placement because I have very less time. I want to teach you so many things. So I did the placement part ready. So with the help of this only, I made it all the placement. You can see here. Even this borders also, you can draw only one or two. And you can place it. You can repeat that things. Like this, you can repeat it. And one more thing I want to tell you about the material. Material is very important thing, what you are using. See, for the watercolors, because it's you have to use so many colors in this, variety of colors. So what you have to do is, you have to use a good quality of paper. It is 200 GSM paper. It's especially come for the watercolors and all. You can go for the higher version also, 300 and 250 GSM also. Not use the beyond this, because you are using the watercolors, so much of water. So you cannot use 140 GSM and 180 GSM. So now we quick to start our watercolors. So I'm going to use today my Brewster watercolors. This is very good quality, nice pigment in this. So I'm going to use, first I will do the base color of my lehenga. So this is my base color. So I just leave the embellishment part and fill in between the blue color. You can take your comfortable brush if you're not comfortable with the 5 or little thicker one. You can use 2 number of round brush and thinner brush. Even if you're not comfortable to do the watercolor in this, you can use this kind of staedtler. You can fill in between. But I will suggest you to do the watercolor because it will give you more finishing. See, bridal wear is something very important garment. Whenever you show to your client or anybody, they have some emotional things. So you have to work so much of detailing in that. You need to give so much of time to your garment, especially the bridal. I know it will take time. You should have the patience. Then only you can finish. So here I'm not diluting much my color. I'm taking a little bit thicker. Even you can use the poster colors. But poster colors is something you should be very good in the coloring part. Sometimes you cannot change if you apply. You cannot change the way. But watercolor is something whenever you use, you can change the things. And I will tell you about this croquis. I'm using the well head. As you know, you have head theory, 8 head. But in the fashion, we will use the 10 or 12 head theory. So lehenga and all, like, it's very taller thing. How much tall you will show, that would look good. So I'm using 12 head theory. For the gowns, lehenga, where you want to show more embellishment, more your flowy garment, you can use the 12 head theory. See, I'm using colors. So I just fill one part and move to the end. So this is blue color is done now. Now let it be dry. And I'll show you your skin tone. What are the colors you can use for the skin tone? See, you can use this kind of pancake also. So for the skin tone, we need three colors. Like one is white. If you talk about the percentage, your white is more. White will be more. And I'm going to use now this lemon yellow color for the second part, my second color, and very less amount of crimson red. This is crimson red. So I got this color. I feel this is a little darker, so I'll take more of white. So you can check your color first in one sheet. Before coloring on paper, I will apply a little bit of water on the skin. Make sure your water will be clean and brush also. And apply a little bit color. Do not color fully, only in the corners. Same way I will do for other neck and other parts of skin. So mainly in the illustration, everything is same, like your jewelry and everything. Only the bridal is some, you have a lot of jewelry and the emulsion part. So that only the most important, how you show your textures on your illustration. Because once you color, everything becomes flat. I want to show here the transparent dupatta over here, but still I'll give my skin tone. Now let it be dry this and I'll move to this part. I'm planning to give a pink color for the flowers and the green color for the leaves and all. So first, I will give the base of my colors. Wherever the flowers, you just apply this base color. Now I'll move to my leaves and all. Here also I will use the diluted color of green. Diluted in the sense more of water. So if you use a good GSM paper, so it won't give you trouble. If you use a less GSM, what will happen when you use the water, all the paper will come off because it's a very less of cotton. So if it is GSM more, it will absorb your water. Means they will use more of cotton. So material is very important. It depends like what kind of material you are going to use on paper. Now you can see like a little blue part is pending, so it is covering that area. If you want to show the golden color, we will apply the golden yellow. But not the directly golden yellow. You can mix this lemon yellow and golden yellow. Because always you have to show the three tones, whatever you do, darker, medium, and lighter. So I'm just giving the base of my gun. See, for the jewelry and all also I'll use this yellow. Now for the dupatta, for the shawl, you have to do the whitewash, I mean, in the seams. But first I'll cover the blouse also with a darker blue, because we need a darker blue blouse. Here the water quantity is less, less. And now I'm not applying the water before. When you want to show some transparency in the garment, that time you will use first water and then color. But if you want thicker part, no need to use the water. So now this is my shawl area. I just put the water first. For the water apply, you can take this kind of flat brush. This is 8 number. So it is easy to apply the water. Even I'll cover, because this is transparent, so I will apply in this part also. Now I'll take very little amount of color in my brush, very little. Now you can see it is very transy. You cover your hand also with that, because you want to show transparent look. how much effort you will give your garment, that much, in your sketch, that much it will be look good. There's so many water techniques. So where the transparent area, I just filling with my brush. Small areas, I will take the small brush. One by one, because now I need time to dry this part, so you cover other part that way. See, whenever you do poster colors, you make sure fan is off, because poster colors, once it will dry, you cannot move, and it will give you patches also when you do the on the fan. But I'm using watercolor, so not is a problem in that case. So now again I'll move to my skin tone. See, I gave one base. Now I'm using this Tedler colors to give the depth. So you always remember you have to show everywhere three tones. It won't make your, if you maintain the three tones, it won't make your illustration flat. In the fashion industry, the illustration have a big role, because we can say there's one kind of language between you and your client. So I'll to suggest who's joining this right now, you make your illustration good. This is the first step for your illustration. How much effort you give here, you can see later in the garments also, that much effort will come. So don't take easy your illustration, give more time. How much your language, this language you will learn nicely, that much you can make your clients. So you also give that. So this way you can give me the depth of your skin tone. Now I'll move to this part. Here also you can use little bit top of this tiddlers. This is watercolor pencil, so you just apply and you can use later in watercolor also. Top of this. So use mixed medium. Try to learn the mixed medium. Don't try in one medium itself. So you can see the watercolor here. So it will give you again, you have to maintain the three tones. And after this, top of this, I will use some gel pen also. Like I have this kind of gel pens, it will give you more depth. You have this pink color. So you can see in the garments, the embroidery embellishment part, you have the stitches. So with the help of lines, you can show the stitches part. Even I'm using some orange color also on top of this. And this part of my border, dupatta border, I'll use red color, crimson red again. And again, I will leave that part and fill the border. And the balanced flowers, I just do again the yellow color. So this way you can show the borders and all. Now with the help of blue color only, you can make bangles and jewelry. You can work on that area. The same color, whatever you're using there, same color you apply, because we used to wear the matching part. So you have to, you are the designer, you have to think about head to toe, what jewelry she is going to wear, everything you have to decide. It's not like you are the garment designer, means you have to design only garments. You have to head to toe, you have to think. Even you have to think, you have to ask to the person, where is the wedding? What is the timing? That way only you have to choose the colors. So you should know everything. So this way I already actually finished few part, because we have very less time. This way only we color this thing. So you can see like this color I did over here fully, this part. And I will show you some after this. What I have to do is, when you finish all this thing, you have to take the Staedtler colors and you have to give the depth, means you have to do shading. Once it will dry everything, you have to do shading part. Here also I'm using the tones. See, darker tone, lighter tone. You have to use that. Keep always your tissue paper near to you, because whenever you do work, your hand will become dirty and it will make your paper also dirty. So, yeah. see where the shading will come when you say fabric will fold, and you know, top of that, my shawl is up top of the lehenga, so here only the shading part, the darker tone, the shadow will drop on the lehenga, so that part could be darker. Even the last, I will use the black also sometimes. See, so even here also you have to show some shading part. Even I will take the little black color also finally, I mean, to show more depth. And after, once you do the shading, again you can use your brush. Here also some in the shawl also, I'll show few darker tones. I'll use my brush, and be careful when you are using in the, you should not take much water because it will spoil your full sketch if you do the much, if you take the much water. So top of the pencil color, you have to take very less water. Even you extra water, you can wipe it. Take color, you just spread the water over there. Quantity of water and you know where you move the brush, it is all experience. How much you play with your colors, that much you experience, like how much water important, how much the color quantity. This won't come in one day. How much practice you'll do, that much you'll understand. You have to play with the colors. Don't think like this, I will do, it will spoil. Let it play. If you spoil 10, then 11th one you will do good. Do experiment for the your embellishment path. Take the swatches and try on your just a square, try to do, get that fabric if relatively dry this. This kind of golden color pens also will come, but it won't give you that much effect on your garments. Even this kind of fabric colors will come. But still, I can see if you use this colors, it will give you very dark tone, not golden. It will give you copper colors. Even the golden also, if you use, you know, it won't give you that much effect. So apply the yellow, and on top of that, some embellishment part you can do, some emboss effect you can do it. See, I want to take out my swan, so I'll just apply a little bit black over here. And I will merge with my colors. So this way you can like emboss effect if you want to give him your this embellishment part, you can do it. I will use this finishing part when you end of your sketch. So I'll put some stone of my jewelry the same color. Even you can use the final touch, you can use the gel pens also, black color. So just merge the colors. So also get some emboss effect. Same technique I use. Whatever I use here in this flowers, for the blouse also I use the same. First I apply the base color and then top of that. Steadler and then finally your gel pens. Even this kind of poster colors will come. You can use this also for the final task, but not much, very little amount you can use it. So you can see in this, I did the dot, dot, dot and all. So how to, you can use this tip of your brush and you can take this some colors in your palette and just dip in your brush and just give the dot. Like this, you can place your dupatta. See, there's a lot of techniques. When you start working on it, you will come to know. But it will take time to dry, so make sure your hand should not go when you are working. So try to do in the last moment. And once it will dry, again you can do top of this some shading part. Even you can use on your swan also some gold anything. So I showed you so many ways of glitter, how to show. You can show one yellow color and then gel pens, now this poster colors. This all will indicate your zari work and gold colors. But whenever you use this color, this is very transy. If you apply just like that, it is transy. So you just apply first yellow and then top of that you can use this golden. Now finally I will use some white tone also. Here and there. To give the shine on your work. For this work, you can take very thin brush. Like this is, I'm taking 000. Because you have to keep very tiny. Even you can use this kind of Rolan white pen also, but it won't work that much great. So I'm using acrylic white. Acrylic white will give you nice shine. See, you have lot of detailing in the bridal wear. Not everywhere, little, somewhere. even for the swine also, you can, once it will dry, let it be dry that by the time I just finish my flower pot. So we know the base color, how to do, and you know, the how to draw the property. We already know in the fashion field. I'm talking about that person. Only where we lack, like how to show the more of detailing. Because in the bridal sketch, you need a lot of thing. I mean, your jewelry is there, embellishment part is more, and that too very small area. You have the same area, and you have to show in that area itself so much of detailing. So you need to use so many mediums. You use poster colors, watercolors, acrylic colors, gel pens, your watercolor pencils. Yeah, it will take time. If you want to do hurry hurry, it won't be. You need patience. In this, like, when I designed this one, do you remember this? In the first itself, I did the designing part, and then what I did, I trace it. But I'm not showing here full part because the fabric will fold, and few part you can see, and few will be high. So maintain that, because if you draw the same thing everywhere, then it becomes flat. So you should, when you the garment is on the dress form, it will take the folds. So somewhere it's like you can see the fully part, and somewhere. So in the illustration also, you have to, in the garment, you have to show some part very clear and some is fold. It depends on the posture, what posture she is standing, that way it will be work. The last but not the least, because there is a lot of thing we can do it in this. Here also use very little, maintain the water quantity, because if you take lot of water, your full sketch will be spoiled. You have to maintain the texture. You can see over here the pencil color texture, so that you have to maintain. Same time you have to merge your color. face. If you are comfortable, you do. If you are not comfortable, first do practice and then come on the face. If still you are not able to do, you just try. Try 100 times, definitely you will get. Because it's a plus point of your illustration. So if you get that, it's well and good. Now this part is a little bit dry, I feel, so I'll get a little bit blue over here. Whenever you use the watercolors, make sure you have two, three containers of water. Because if you keep one container, your all darker tone will go to your lighter tone and it will spoil your illustration. So make ready everything. Don't try in the hurry. Keep all your water and your tissue papers and your rough cloth. Everything is near, should be near to you. Because this small thing only make your sketch good. We are not bothered. We just take one cloth and we'll sit. No, don't do that. I'll take this brush. And I'll wipe my water, not much water, I just a very little amount of water. Just for the finishing. Here I'm taking a little more water because here I have to show the depth. If you are not comfortable with this big brushes, you can try the small brushes also. This is done. So you can see, like, step by step you all did all the things. This way you can not even try, see, this is the poster colors. So this way also you can try. Here I did the embellishment, but just a scribbling. I gave one base color and I just scribble my pens. So this way you can try so many ways of your color.
Thank you, ma'am, for your illuminating and very wonderful workshop. Appreciation letter will be displayed as a token of love. Appreciation from our side. Kindly accept it, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Now I invite Ms. Illavarisi, ma'am, to give the oath of thanks.
Good afternoon to one and all present here. On behalf of Dr. MGR Educational and Research Institute, I take this opportunity to propose the oath of thanks for this one-day national level webinar organized by your institute. Heartfelt thanks to your Honorable President, Engineer ACS Arun Kumar Sir, for accepting our request. A special thanks to eminent speaker of the day, Ms. Zia Khan, Fashion Illustrator, for her wonderful and valuable session. Thank you, ma'am. I would like to thank your joint register, respected Dean, Dr. A.R. Arunachalam Sir, Academy, and Dr. K. Senu Kumar Sir, Administration, for the continuous support in conducting various programs. It's my honor to thank Ms. Masmoda Begum, ma'am, HOD of Fashion Design Department, for providing me opportunity to deliver the oath of thanks. A special thanks to all the participants for your presence and continued support. I would also thank all the staff members and HODs. A special thanks to Mr. Ganesh Babu Sir for his technical support. Thank you, one and all.
I hope this session was enlightened and informative, and there are a lot more upcoming events are there, so kindly stay tuned. And admissions are open for the BSc Fashion Design Department. Do follow us on all our social pages. Thank you. Stay safe and stay healthy. Thank you.
Dr. NGR Educational and Research Institute.